Every now and then we come across a book and I think, this is Lee's bag, this is Lee's jam, he'll know all about this, like he's an expert. Well, no, there's a semi-clad woman on the cover, that's not what I was thinking.
All right, thanks.
But Sophie Cachia is an influencer like yourself.
Look.
She kind of is involved in the sporting world, which you clearly were.
Well, she didn't play sports, she dated a sportsman.
Yes, so but she's from a sporting
kind of a
family.
Yeah,
I know. And she's been on Survivor. I'm like, Lee, here you go.
She didn't do all that well.
Not as well as you.
Ah, thanks. Look, it's interesting you talk about that word influencer because I really struggle with that word. I have some followers. I was lucky just from Survivor to get them.
You're a good fella. People are interested in you.
Also, when people sort of go, oh, you know, you're an influencer, I get
cringy. Like,
cringy. But I think Sophie kind of likes it. And
she built a brand.
She built a brand. She's got a following. But she also wants to be known as a businesswoman, an entrepreneur.
She sells pyjamas.
She sells PJs.
They're very nice.
But I find this story was, look, a little bit interesting. It's about her going through a few changes in life.
It's sort of part of building the brand. I almost feel like this is the next stage in building a brand, which is what we see a lot of influencers and branding people do. The telling this story in her book, you could say it's quite brave but it's also just her living her life and selling her pyjamas as well. So pretty much she was married to an AFL football player for a long while.
Yep.
And at a certain point, met a woman and went, oh, hang on a minute. And
I like women.
I like women as well. And it's kind of the journey, and it is very honest. The ex-husband, Jared, starts the book and gives us his side of the story.
That's what I find really interesting.
I thought, good on you, mate.
Yeah.
You meant
to say that to your ex. Hey, by the way, I'm writing a book about my new love. Do you want to read
the intro? Yeah, and they're still good friends, which is, there's lots of good stuff in here. So he tells the story. So basically it's called Then There Was Her, and it's about her journey to finding herself and being with a woman. But she's now with a different woman and she's engaged to a different woman who is another sportswoman. So she's having a new, big, fabulous life and she's telling everyone all about it.
Maybe there's another book coming out soon.
There might be another book. And you know, it's really interesting though, but I think this is kind of a generational thing, right? This will appeal to her followers. This will appeal to people who, and I know, you know what? If it gives someone comfort, someone the courage to step out and say, hey, here's me, I've made a big change, then more power to it.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about being authentic on social media, you know, she said she was living the best life. She had, you know, two kids, white picket fence, you know, an AFL husband. But she felt that she was not being authentic. So in a positive way, I think that she's decided to go out there, tell her story. When you put yourself out there like that, you're bound for a bit of criticism from, you know, from certain angles of the public.
Yeah.
But then
it's all the other thing. And I think that's the thing when you talk about the influencer stuff and what makes you a bit uncomfortable.
Yeah.
You know, so her trip on Survivor was pretty recent. She went on with her sister and it was very dramatic,
dramatic.
In the end. So I think, but it's all part of it, right? This is how people build their lives and their entrepreneurial lives
these days. This world, they have to stay relevant. And whether it's writing a book, whether it's going on a reality TV show. So who knows what's next? I mean, the thing is for her is her business will probably maintain her consistency and but then she'll go out and try and find ways to promote herself. That's how that industry works.
The writing itself to me, it's pretty simple, it's pretty straightforward. It's someone as if they're talking to you, and that's the way
you'll
a lot of these...
You'll get it done on a train ride from Brisbane to the Sunshine Coast.
Yeah, that's probably
pretty
a really
much,
good
yeah.
description. So, and they're very confident. I mean, I guess that's what you have to be when you're living this life. You need to be really confident. So she's very happy to tell you how good she is at what she does and how she does it.
Super confident.
It's a good story if you need to, if someone's going through a stage and needs to make a change and they want to kind of be honest about their lives. Great read. If you're into perhaps how you might want to grow your brand, maybe that's helpful. Not my jam, but I think it's the right kind of book for the audience that she's trying to appeal to.
Yeah, I think this will appeal to all of her followers and as you said, Vic, for people who are sort of going through big changes in their life, maybe they might get something out of it as well.
So anyway, back to you. Should we start a book?
So the book, what is it going to be called? We'll think about this workshop. We'll get back to
Lee survived. We've got a little while.
We've got a while. Let's workshop it. Am I semi-naked on it?
You're semi-naked. I'd read it.
Thanks. I gotta read it.